Hello and welcome to episode 2 of my Beginner's Guide to Evernote 10. And in this episode, we're going to do the next best thing after setting up a few notebooks, and that is to establish or create a few notes. Well, in particular, I'm going to show you how to create one note, and then you can do the rest after that. And also, as I promised in the previous episode, I want to introduce you to Evernote's web clipper, which you can start preparing for because we will be covering that in more detail in the next episode. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Evernote, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my new demo account now, and I'll show you how to get started or how to create your very first note. Okay, in the previous episode, I took you through the process of creating notebooks. So if you haven't set up your notebooks yet, I would strongly recommend that you go back and you watch episode 1 of this beginner's guide and set up your notebooks so that you're ready to go. In this episode, I am now going to take you into creating notes. So essentially, in my demo account right here, we don't have any notes at all. By the way, let's just get rid of this notification. So I have no notes in here right now. So there's a number of ways you can see. I can click on the green button down here, create new note, or as you're going to go to it more often than not, you're going to click here, create new note. Now, just to give you an indication, you can actually hit the drop down menu there and you can create a blank note. You have some templates right here, which is to do, a meal planner, a daily reflection, meeting note, project plan, lecture notes, essay outline, and weekly planner. So you actually have some options open to you. For now, I'm just gonna create a blank note. And to do that, I can do that quickly right from there. So now we've created the note. Now, essentially, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do really unimaginatively my first note. There you go. I'm not being very imaginative at all. Now, right here, I can start writing and I can drag and drop stuff in here. Now, the thing is, you can also click on here and you can be taken to Evernote's template chooser, which is a separate website, and you can pull down your own templates. Now, if you have the premium version, you can actually create your own templates and save notes as a template. More on that in a future episode. For now, all I want to do is to give you how to format your first note. So I'm going to do, this is my first, it's not, but my first Evernote note. I should have copied and pasted this, but there we go. So this is my first Evernote note. This is how to create a note. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm just going to show you some of the formatting options that you have right here. So first up, I can make this into a title. I can just highlight that. I can go to here where it says normal text, and I can go and say large header, medium header. So let's make that a medium header. And I can now, if I want, I can actually make this a bullet point, or I can make it a numbered list, or I can make it a checklist. So there's a few options that I have there. I'm just going to remove those. I can also, if I wish, change the color of this. So if I just go in here, let's just change the color of the header. So I can click on this and I can change the color of the header by going into here. Evernote will give me a few options. So we'll stick with Evernote green and I can do that. And this one, if I wish, I can just hit the highlight button and I can highlight that. So this is really, really some really good formatting tools. And this is probably one of the reasons why I use Evernote more than I would ever use Apple Notes, because whenever I'm doing online courses and I'm taking notes, this is really how I generally take notes. I create headers and I do highlighting, and I can't do that in Apple Notes, but that's just my own personal preference. So let's just remove that highlighting. So those are just a few of the additional things that you can do. In addition to that, I'm just going to get really, really boring because I'm just going to copy and paste this. So save me some typing again. So let's just go down here and just type this. And so what I can also do here is I can actually just create my checklist like this, and I can do my numbered list like that. So you've got options like this. But there are other things that you can do. For example, let's say that I am doing my an online course. If you go up to here, you now have a number of other options that you can actually add. I can add a photo, I can add a divider, I can add a checkbox, I can do all sorts of things in here. So if I go down here, I can go into the add and add a table. And now I can do all sorts. So header, I'm really not very imaginative. Header one, header two, header two. Now, the reason why I've done that is what you can do is you can click on the sidebar here. This highlights that. Use a drop-down menu, and I can now create a header color like that. And with inside that note, and just again, I'm going to save myself a lot of time here. I'm just going to copy these. I can actually copy and paste that in there. Let's make this a little bit wider. And now I can do the same formatting as I showed you before. So, for example, inside this table, I can do bullet points. I can do all sorts of things in there, and you can highlight and so on. So this is another thing that you can add in here. You, of course, as I say, you can actually add photos. You can add all sorts of things into your note. So essentially, that's all you need to do. Now, let's go back here. What you'll notice is I created this note. It's in my inbox, and there's no tag. So what I'm going to do is I can now say this is a personal note. So if I go up to here, click on that, I can then choose, okay, move that to my personal, and I'm going to move. Now it's going to go straight into, see, it's going into my personal. I'm now going to add a task, a tag, and I'm just going to put a sample. So I've now got a tag called sample. And because I've not got any tags, I just tap on that, and I've got a sample tag. So when we go into my personal here, you'll see that my note is here, and it's, I'm going to add the tag. Type to add sample, create sample tab. There we go. So I've got my sample is now there. So you can see that I've got my tag in there. I've got my note right here. Now go back to the home section right up here, and you'll see that my new note is right there. It's already captured that first note. Now, again, as I mentioned with the home screen, you can actually create notes directly from here. That's really quite simple. And you have all sorts of things that you can do right from here. So there you go. That's all I really wanted to show you this week, is just creating that first note. But before we go any further, because I did promise in the previous episode that I would show you the Evernote web clipper. But the first thing you have to do is you have to download it. Now, if I go into an article right up here, so let's go into my learning center because it's right there. And I'm going to go to my all courses, and let's say that I go into this particular course right here. I already have this set up, so I can click on that, and it's now going to save that to my Evernote. Now the thing is, this is set up. Let's just check where that's set up. Yeah, this is set up for a different account. So if I save this clip right now, it's not going to show up in the demo account that I'm just showing you now. But just to show you that this is something that we're going to cover in more detail in the next episode. But what you need to do is, if you're using Chrome or using Safari, you need to download the web clipper into your extensions. I think it's called, is it extensions? Yeah, your Cloud or Chrome, your web browser's extensions. So the web clipper is available in Safari, Firefox, and Chrome. I think it's also available in Microsoft Edge. If you haven't done so already, I strongly recommend that you get yourself that into your browser ready for the next episode, because that's what we're going to go through in the next episode, which is the web clipper. Now, while we're here, you can choose a number of options. So for example, I can do the article, which will remove a lot of the formatting, and I don't have any ads in my learning center. I can do the simplified article, and that's just going to remove pretty much all the images and just save it. I can do screenshot. I can actually create a bookmark. So it will just create the image and then a summary. So there's a few options, but we're going to go into that in a lot more detail in the next episode. So there you go. That's all you need to know for... Whoops, we're going to get back to my Evernote. There we go. All you need to know right now about collecting notes. So I strongly recommend that you get yourself set up with Evernote, get your first note in there, have a download the web clipper so that you're ready to go in the next lesson. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.